play. I'm gonna try to get into the stream here quickly. On my phone this time, because my phone is more reliable than my tablet is. With a rebel yell, she cried, "More, more, more!" Oh, end of the night, hell. Let me just search myself up real quick. So I'm actually a little early. I'm like 9 or 10 minutes early. Mo, mo, mo. She want mo. So I'm in the stream. I know we are indeed going. Okay, we're good. First match is going to be me and Rusev. I just want to make it clear that we are 7th in line for the United States Championship. But, right now we are going against our rival right now is The Undertaker. The freaking Undertaker. Because last stream was probably the best Jeff Hardy stream I've ever done in terms of people showing up and fan interaction. Yeah, because I asked, who do you want our rival to be now that we had the option? Because we got out of that whole Ryback, Seth Rollins situation. And someone commented and said they wanted The Undertaker. So, our current rival is The Undertaker.
Let's just call it for what it is. An all-out brawl. This match is not...
Here on WWE Superstars, a show that I never really liked. But I don't even think they do it anymore, do they? And we are against Rusev. I mean, I guess they still do it. They have it in this game, but they never really did anything with it. It was never really important. It doesn't appear as though any damage has been done. Tell us about the only important match I think they ever showed on Superstars was Cody Rhodes versus Shane McMahon was on Superstars, which I don't know why that would be on Superstars. That sounds like it should be a high mid-card Raw match, but because that sounds really good, like Shane McMahon. Considering he doesn't compete anyways, and also referee is out. I call him referee, that is his name.
Wow, he's still down after that. You could call this a good old fashioned butt whooping.
Yeah, that's exactly what we're witnessing. A butt whooping.
Oh, okay. Wait, nice reversal.
I feel like sometimes on live streaming I just get real quiet real fast. Because I'm trying to not make a fool of myself. Because if I make a fool out of myself in videos, I can edit that out. Oh my god, Rusev is decking my shit right now. I don't have any reversals either.
The danger level just picked up a notch now that the action is good.
Danger level? Welcome to the jungle. Something, 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 Guns N' Roses music.
Nice reversal. Looks like he's pinpointing the back.
We've talked at great lengths about Rusev's annihilating offense. Well, the way the Bulgarian brute finishes opponents is equally alarming.
He reversed it. He powerbombed me. I was going for my, like, middle rope hurricanrana.
Actually hear the victim's bones break.
Holy shit. He has been dominating me this whole match. Hurricanrana.
This guy can go toe-to-toe with anybody. We've really seen one amazing move after another in this one. Great one-on-one action here tonight. It doesn't get much better than this.
Okay.
Trying to get under his opponent's skin with this one. This is going to be
I'm gonna jump to the outside.
One way or another. No kidding.
Jeff Hardy move. Jeff Hardy. There we go.
In his quest to expunge WWE of all its superstars, Rusev wants to be the only man standing with every WWE title in his possession.
What?
Oh my gosh, Cole, that's a terrifying scenario. But Rusev is the one superstar that has the skills and heinous visions of dominance to make that a reality. I don't think the WWE is safe.
Correction. WWE has been fucking up Rusev's career. Like, it could be a lot better.
Wow,
I'm laid out.
Down
okay, I'm getting up.
He's bringing it back inside the ring now.
I can't blame him. Keep it in the ring. Look out.
There we go. Took my control. Didn't even need a reversal.
If he keeps up this pace, this could turn real ugly, real fast.
Okay, I'm going to hit Rusev with Whisper in the Wind and a twist and try to get the pin. I don't think that's going to work, but I need to save my finisher for resiliency in case Rusev, like, starts whooping my ass. That's what I'm going
to
do.
More of a fight. That was a thing of beauty. Just amazing.
Come on. There we go. There's my signature.
Twist of fate.
Man, that's one of my all-time favorite moves. He's having a seriously hard time getting back to his feet.
Yeah, there's
that.
Not a chance I'm going to get this pin, but I'm going to try anyways.
Makes the cover.
Didn't think so. Okay.
Seems like these guys are letting out a lot of pent-up frustration tonight.
Hurricanrana! We've really seen one amazing move after another in this one.
Another amazing singles contest.
Even
these two never cease to entertain.
It seems like now that I'm playing this as Jeff Hardy, when I played it the very first time, it's a lot easier than I'm playing as Jeff Hardy right now. I don't know why that is, but it is.
If you're just tuning in, I want to welcome everyone to this broadcast of WWE, coming to you from the capital of the Golden State, Sacramento.
Sacramento, California?
That's gotta be it. I mean,
I think...
That's a finishing move, people.
Oh, that... He used a signature on me.
He's going for the pin. This could be it. I think he's got him.
And I just lost. Holy shit. I just lost like that. For real.
You want to talk about Craw? There were some unbelievable...
Here's your winner, Rusev!
Son of a bitch. Cause I'm straight out of Compton. Sorry, I have like a cinnamon bun thing. And I'm starving. Cause I haven't... I barely ate any lunch at all today. Did I just see Triple H versus somebody on Superstars? That would never actually happen. So we have a rematch against Rusev. We're almost to Night of Champions, where we're going to fight, of course, The Undertaker. But right now we have to go through Rusev on SmackDown. Not really a problem, not really a problem. Unless he, like, you know, beats us again. In which case, minor problem. According to my phone, we've already been going for 10 minutes, which is ridiculous. But anyway.
This one could be the match of the night.
Okay, oh, he's gonna shove me into the corner. And then I'm gonna come back with the referee gets between us. Slap.
Looking fresh out there.
There
you're
we go.
You're not going to lose many matches when you're competing at full health.
Well executed offense.
No one's backing down here.
Okay, now I'm pushing him into the corner. And the ref's going to come between us. And then I'm going to back up. Punch him in the jaw. You bastard.
Domineering power. Surreal athleticism. And along with his social ambassador, Lana, reviles in human suffering and complete destruction. The more Rusev's detested by WWE fans, the more agony the brute happily doles out.
Yeah, and one of the things that's most horrifying about Rusev is that
his chain wrestling is fast.
He shows absolutely no emotion. None. Nothing. That's when you know you're dealing with the worst type of evil.
A ton of talent, a ton of ability. Certainly someone to keep an eye on.
Okay. Slamming him to the fucking floor. Got him. Throw him into the potion.
Oh, out of nowhere!
Look at this athleticism. Rusev's ability to decimate makes him appear like more machine than man. This nightmare, the brute, makes every movement one of pain for opponents. Watching Rusev compete is like watching a sanctioned mauling of another human being. Rusev's that dominant.
Oh, wait, nice reversal.
Suplex? I don't know why I was about to say superplex.
Looking good so far, not much damage, if any, has been absorbed.
Whoa.
Uh-oh, look who's coming out here.
Wait a second, I don't see him. Could this be a big distraction?
If it is, it's definitely working.
No.
Yeah, the strength of Rusev and his devotion to Vladimir
Putin's
ideologies has
that gave him a finisher and took all my momentum away.
Rusev is so commanding that if you blink, the bell could ring. Rusev could strike and just
my foot's in the rope, right?
Because Rusev's going to end it with the accolade.
Well, I guess that's only fitting for this big Russian.
Okay. So he tried to hit me with his. The accolade, which is his finisher. Now he's going to try to get the pin on me.
The shoulders are down. Two.
And a kick out.
And
no,
that's all that
of course not.
This match continues.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
Reversal. Rusev showing his skills.
They're not dreaming. This snapmare is for real.
What a move. Man, you land hard after that snapmare.
Okay, I got the chain wrestling there.
When I think of the offensive onslaughts that occur at the hands of Rusev,
the Undertaker trying to trip me up so I would lose this match. Trying to get in my head for this for the pay-per-view coming up.
An unstoppable attack that no one can survive.
Whisper in the wind. There we go.
And again, the mind games are played.
Karana.
How impressive was that?
I'm gonna beat you this time, Rusev. You're my bitch. He's not hurt at all, though.
Great
like, none of his limbs are
tonight.
Damaged
it
at all.
It doesn't get much better than this. The way that Rusev is able to channel his power and turn his entire body into a weapon of destruction is disturbing. You see a perfect example of Rusev's power and agility. Look at his super kick. The 300-pounder leaps in the air, then drills his opponent right in the face with a perfect kick.
Yeah, you know, Cole, I thought I saw every type of super kick or savant kick style in my 40 years in this business until I saw Rusev nearly decapitate an opponent with his version. Rusev's a behemoth. It's that simple.
Get on the fucking guardrail, you bastard.
Not this.
Oh, he's at the count of seven. Wait, give me that count out victory, though. Any victory is a good victory. And we won by count out, but still a victory. Still a victory.
Well, I don't know how you can pick out highlights from that match. The whole match was highlights. One in a million is the only way to describe this match. Oh, they threw everything they had at each other in this match.
Here's your winner.
Okay.
Big win, albeit via count out.
That was simply a case of one guy determined to prove his dumb.
All righty then. Moving on to superstars, I guess. Where, I don't know who my opponent's going to be, but I bet it's either going to be Rusev or Taker. Hopefully it's not Taker. I want to save that to be special for Night of Champions. Oh, rank increased. I'm 6 now. Getting closer to challenging Big Match John for that title. Daniel Bryan. Oh, I thought Night of Champions was right after this, but I guess it isn't. D-Bry. He's a pretty, like, famous dude. He might give me a good match. Alrighty.
There's no other way to put it. This one-on-one match is going to be a struggle.
Now, nigga, you don't run at me. I run at you. You understand that?
Entertaining the idea of backing down. This is good.
He's taking not chain wrestling.
The back of the head that render most men completely immobile.
And he may so he has a lot of reversals. Race. Like a lot. Like 5, the most you can get. Wait, what does the authority want? I don't care. I mean, I don't even like the authority, so. I like the extra experience points. I mean, they're not that much extra, but.
Just about anything to get to the top. I like it. That's the way it should be.
Let me just finish off the rest of this cinnamon roll.
Totally cracked a couple ribs on that landing.
So I tried to go Air Jeff and completely ate it, so.
I'll say one thing about Daniel Bryan. You'll be hard-pressed to find a more well-traveled superstar than him. That beard has been around the globe, performing just about anywhere they'll let him.
Looking to build momentum.
Well, we're on the move here.
I don't think Bryan ever competed on Superstars. Well, maybe he has, I don't know.
Up and over with a suplex. Looking to fly.
Oh my Jesus.
Attack continues.
Oh man, this is getting tough to watch.
Michael, right in the
Daniel
stomach.
Bryan has an arsenal. For every continent he set foot on during his travels, Daniel put more tricks up his sleeve. And all those different styles and tactics have shaped him into some kind of hybrid monster. Daniel Bryan with a great offensive show. My God, his body's been through hell.
Okay, it's easier to damage him.
And I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe.
It's easier to damage him than it is to damage, what is the other guy's name? Rusev. I don't know why I couldn't remember his name for just
each
a second
of these
there.
Competitors is looking for the slightest hint of weakness in the other.
Well, that's a strategy you have to always have in the back of your head, Cole. If you ever see
get
a weakness
your bullshit
in your
out of here.
You gotta jump on
get back in there.
Look out. He's got his sights set on that neck region. Well, we can think back on some of the major moments of Daniel Bryan's career, and King, who can ever forget the way he won his first WWE heavyweight title?
Oh, yeah, it was under the wildest of circumstances, Michael. Daniel cashing in his Money in the Bank contract in 2011 to take the title off, of all people, Big Show. I mean, you talk about David versus Goliath. Oh, man, does he have that arm submission in tight?
He's trying to get me to tap with the armbar. Fuck you. I just got up and punched him
he's
in the face.
Reminding him that he's here. We're looking at complete domination here. Quick thinking to avoid that.
And again, the mind games are played.
Daniel Bryan's pin of Big Show for the World Heavyweight Championship has always been viewed as controversial by some. After all, it was the world's strongest man, Mark Henry, who had already flattened Show and knocked him out cold. All Daniel had to do was pin an unconscious man. Some called the move gutless, some smart. That's what Money in the Bank is all about. Opportunity. We're looking at complete domination here. This could be all she wrote.
Gonna get the
That's
twist.
It. It's over. It's over.
It's gonna take a lot to change the tide of this one.
Let me get the pin here. I'm not gonna win by it, but I'll get the pin. There we go. Jeff's like, oh my god.
You know, you can call
oh my
Daniel
god, why did I not win right there?
Gutless if you want. But the fact is that he earned that Money in the Bank contract. And that it was his right to cash it in any way he wanted. He saw his chance, he took it, and it's always going to be one of the most memorable moments of his life.
Remember, momentum in WWE can turn on a dime and leave you.
It's showing I have absolutely no stamina, but whatever. Superplex.
He's inflicting some serious pain here.
This guy's just getting worn out. Oh, wait. Nice reversal.
The back is the largest area on the human body and thus always a target.
I know what you mean. You know, I've got a weak back.
How long did you have that?
Oh, about a week back.
One of Daniel Bryan's most fierce rivalries was against Randy Orton. Orton accused Daniel.
Oh, that's it!
Oh, shit. I almost reversed that.
Daniel Bryan! Now that's a finishing move right there, people.
Okay, I got the, I got it up. I got it. What? Whoa.
Oh, man. That neck's gotta be hurt after that.
He copyright infringement?
Busted up.
I mean, German suplex isn't copyrighted.
He's still down after that.
It's
move.
Kind of Brock Lesnar, but it's not really
there.
Copyrighted.
Making a statement here.
Okay.
Oh my! Boy, he's really done his homework for this match.
Big knee.
Rivalry with Randy Orton was special. I mean, when in every match the two just went hold for hold and move for move. There were so many close calls.
I'm gonna hit this one time.
I have a funny feeling the Bryan Orton battle is not over just yet. Uh-oh.
What? No. No.
Yes, lock.
don't be that guy right now.
Yes! There's no escaping this! I guess he's done with that move.
You're stupid. AI broken. AI broken.
Work is being put in by Daniel Bryan. Few superstars are as dominant as this guy.
What's the twist? Dude, the twist. I think I made that joke like every...
Big move coming.
Sit the fuck down. Rude.
Catching a beating. Climbing the turnbuckle.
Stop. No. Stop standing. Quit standing. Stop it.
At what point came to the creep in of... What do I have to do to put this match to rest? I don't know. I don't know as a WWE superstar if you ever have those thoughts of self-doubt.
Of course you do, but that's the... Look at this head
time. Incredible!
Sees the opportunity to climb quickly. Climb quickly. Swanton. Good.
It really looks painful.
Did Jerry just say, what are those? What are those? What are those? What are those? Okay, two, three. I just beat Daniel Bryan.
I can't believe it.
Daniel Bryan is like a world title contender, so hopefully that'll bump me up in ratings. I mean, it probably won't considering how this game works. Considering that this game wants me to win like two or three matches and then it'll bump me up one slot. But that should have definitely bumped me up. Okay, apparently I completed the authority thing. I mean, I was gonna make his chest red anyway, but whatever.
Please join me in welcoming my guest. You were mentioned by Triple H as one of the bright young stars in WWE. What do you think about that?
I mean, I'm good, but I hate the authority.
I don't trust it. They don't call Triple H the Cerebral Assassin for nothing. I am one of the brightest superstars in the WWE, but I did not get here by trusting lying filth like Triple H.
There you have it. Back to you guys.
Okay. Shots fired, me hating Triple H. Confirmed. So, we have one more match on SmackDown and one more for another match on Superstars, and then we go to Night of Champions where we will face The Undertaker. The Undertaker. And it's going to be wonderful. I'm kind of cold. Yeah, the heebie-jeebus. Okay, I have a win with all green body parts. Not gonna happen. I'm just not coordinated enough. So I have a match against Kane, the Undertaker's brother. My brother. Oh, brother, my brother. Is what I meant to say. I don't know. Okay. Confirm. The crown. All right, Kane. I'm about to wreck you. I'm about to rock you. Like a hurricane. Oh, two people are here. I didn't even know. It didn't show me on the, screen on my PlayStation like it usually does.
This should be an incredible match.
And if it did, I was unaware. Hello, how are you? How are you today? Hope you've done good and have enjoyed the show thus far. Whenever people come to the stream, I usually acknowledge them. But I didn't know you were here, and for that I am sorry. Please forgive me and enjoy my content.
Tell us about Harvey.
Definitely looking confident.
It's kind of just beating shit at Kane right now. Is the objective here. I could do the little extra authority thing, but I'm probably going to fail because I'm not good enough. It's basically telling me, don't take damage in this whole match. Is basically what it's telling me here.
Attacking from the top. Here we go.
When he gets back in, I'm going to dropkick him.
What do you mean we? He takes to the air. Wow.
I guess I nicked him there.
Look how slow
I guess
he is
I nicked him there.
Here.
So
that was some serious punishment.
He's trying to grab the rope and I'm like, nope. I don't know if it gave me Kane as an opponent because I'm facing Taker at the pay-per-view, or if it gave me Kane as an opponent because that was just a random game choice. Random choice. Hey, let's give him Kane. I'm okay.
Nobody home there.
Oh no.
Nobody home? Cole, that looked like the house has been empty for months. Oh, out of nowhere! Diving into his bag of acrobatic tricks.
Everywhere I go,
hey,
Kane will always know. Charlie Cena's got some. Okay.
Look at these two giving it their all. There's absolutely no quitting them tonight. No breathing room for
what is that move called? That's like Edge's move, where he just like grabbed him and like dropped him. I don't think that was his finisher either. Maybe it was his finisher. That was the execution. Yeah, that was the execution.
As violent and as ruthless a performer as Kane is, he might be even more frightening when he's just standing there looking at you. Those demonic eyes of his scare me just as much as the prospect of getting chokeslammed.
JR King spitting some bullshit about Kane having scary eyes.
The only type of brutality that can take Kane down. He might be injured here.
I'm glad they gave up the whole corporate Kane thing. I never really liked it. I never liked it most of the time. The little thing they did where they were like, corporate Kane and Demon Kane being there in different personas and them not knowing about each other. That entertained me. I mean, a lot of people thought it was dumb, but I enjoyed it at least. I'm pretty easily amused also, so. Yeah.
Not today, too fast. Kane with the
damn
excellent move to get out. Oh, wait, nice reversal. Oh, and he got dropped. Executed perfectly. Extra slow getting back to his base here.
Okay. What can I do to make him pay for what he's done to my family.
He's got him hooked.
What is he doing?
Quick thinking to avoid that.
Oh, get Shrek'd. DDT'd. I'm gonna go for the swanton.
Skyborn. How much damage did that do? A lot from the left. No!
Swanton. Hit it.
What a move. It really looks painful.
Get the pin, though.
Shoulders are down.
Get that one, two, three. Holy shit. I think I completed the authority thing, too. I don't think I took that much damage, did I?
Well, I don't know how you could pick up.
Here's your winner.
That match was good.
Wow, now that was an
completed,
victory.
Yeah. That's probably the quickest, most effective match I've ever done. That efficiency, though. It only took one finisher to beat him.
Welcome back to the show. Let's talk about The Undertaker.
She wants to talk about The Undertaker.
What are your thoughts on him?
I love The Undertaker.
He's been turning it up lately. I can appreciate that. I want the best version of him in the ring. And I think that's what I'm going to get at the pay-per-view. Only time will tell.
The Under-fucking-Taker. Okay.
Thanks
so,
for the time. Back to you.
You're welcome. Okay, so we are going against The Undertaker. The one, the only, The Undertaker. So we have a match on Superstars, and then we have our match against Taker. And we're gonna see if I can beat him. I'm not gonna make any promises, because I don't know if I can beat him, but I'm sure gonna try. I don't know if I'm getting better if Kane is just sucky. Oh, okay, it wants me to watch this match. I'm not going to watch this match. I'm definitely gonna skip it, but yeah. Do, do, do. Do, do, do. Okay, now we have The Undertaker versus Wade Barrett. Where am I?
Hey, wait a minute. Is that? It is. Look who's coming out here.
This isn't his match, but it looks like he's got a bone to pick with one of the superstars.
Yeah, and he doesn't look too happy to see him either.
And Undertaker's like, you can't be here and stuff, and I'm leaving. Okay, here's a little cinematic.
Hard Irish whip into the corner.
I'm over there like, hey, bro.
Uh-oh. Our guest
how's
is
it going?
Here.
And Taker is about to come out here. And I'm like, bro, I'm The Undertaker. I cut my hair, etc. And Wade Barrett.
The time, guys. Uh-oh. See, Michael, I told you.
Okay. Raw, I'm The Undertaker, etc. My exact words, exactly. I think after the Taker match is where I'm going to call this stream, because right now we've been going for about 40. I like that they've given you the ability to rewind streams. That's awesome. Oh, one-on-one. Before our big match, me and Taker on Superstars. Thank you. Okay, fine. I'll just go to my match. Go to match. It's Undertaker's coming out first, and I'm coming out second. That usually indicates that some story thing is going to happen here. I'm guessing there's going to be a story thing where either I attack him or something. And then we're both going to have signatures and we're both going to be kind of beat up at the start of the match. Do 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 do.
Here we go. The match is underway.
The ref gets knocked out.
The referee is out, and these two are turning this match into a brawl.
So me and him are on the outside.
This match is quickly spiraled into chaos after that accident. Without the referee,
you know what? I'm not a heel, but I'm gonna get a cherry in this. I'm not a heel. I'm extreme. What? I'm not a heel, I'm extreme. Oh, can't do it. Ref's up. Never mind. Not gonna use that bat.
Oh wow. Well, the trick sometimes when you get outside the ring is survival. The match becomes almost secondary when you get near all these dangerous objects.
Tell us about Harvey.
The sky's the limit. I see a lot of main events in the future.
It's going to take a lot to change the tide of this one. Oh, out here you have to be able to think on your feet lightning fast. One mistake, one moment of hesitation, and you could find yourself in a world of hurt.
Oh, whoa.
This is a level of destruction.
He hit me with
no
the
expecting. No kidding,
big back body drop.
Ugly. We're going to see a lot of effective moves like that in this match.
Both of these competitors have so much resolve. It's going to take a minor miracle
okay.
to keep one of them down.
So I am going to record the Night of Champions match for a later YouTube video, like I tend to do for this series.
Look at that. Now,
like I did for the Seth Rollins me tag match thing, you know. You should know if you've seen, if you are subscribed.
Mankind at the 1998 King of the Ring. You remember that, Michael? Incredible. I mean, the dead man launched the masochist Mankind off the top of the massive steel cage. My God, that was inhuman.
Okay. So we should be able to put the Undertaker away quicker in this match. Because we're both already, like, pre-hurt.
Great match here, but if you missed any of the matches from this week, go to WWE.com to catch up on all the action.
I go to WWE.com all the time to catch up on the Divas. No, wait. Nice.
Why, of course not. You can never do corner moves in this game. Hardly ever. That's like, it's like corner moves, they have the highest rate of reversals or something.
Let's also remember a match he made famous that helped put an end to many a rivalry. The cast
camel clutch locked in, wrenching on the neck and lower
no.
back.
No. No, Taker. No, 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 no.
He almost
beat me right there.
Of his grip there anyway. He probably figured
you guys,
be
if you
to release the hole now
he almost beat me right there.
Taker's on fire here.
Cause it was like almost entirely row shit. It was almost entirely red. That means he like almost beat me. He could beat me right here. No, he can't. I'm too good.
Taker's in trouble. What a shot! Ow, man, oh man!
Wheelhouse kick.
This match is just one complete highlight reel.
Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy. He's going for it all.
I think he's gonna try to like do his. I'm pretty sure he has. Does he have? Oh, sure he does. Oh God, I'm done. This is the end for me. How could this happen to me? I made my mistake. Oh my God. How is that possible? I survived the tombstone.
A knockdown, drag out brawl, complete with a big stomp.
And these guys are throwing bombs. They're pulling out all the stops.
He's going to try to hit me with his comeback.
body's taking some abuse here, but nothing that can't be shaken off.
Come on, that whisper in the wind. Okay, three minutes of doom. Here we go. Whisper in the wind. Hit that twist. Do the twist.
And now Harvey got it.
Now.
Harvey's just seconds away from victory here.
And now we hit the swanton.
Top rope once more.
They love it up there.
Come on, come on, come on. Ooh, baby, a triple.
He takes to the air.
Swanton.
What a move. It really looks painful.
Come on. Hit that one. Two. Oh, my God.
You can bet every superstar on the roster is crowded around the monitors in the back to see which one of these guys comes out victorious.
I still don't know what skill I want to get next.
He's all business. And that's
I eventually want to get suicide dive, roll up pin, and a bunch of other things like that. I don't want to get springboard dive. I thought I did, but I really don't. It's not that important to me. So.
Some damage has been dished out, but certainly not enough to assume this one's even close to being over. Well, that messed it all right.
Hey, did you look before firing? What an idiot. Wow, cannot believe the Undertaker got out of that one.
Okay, the Undertaker got out of that, of course.
Punishment.
And, I'm beat up. I am beat up bad. I need to just start
permanent headache.
Decking Undertaker's shit.
Great one-on-one action here tonight. It doesn't get much better than this. He's making a statement here with this attack.
Okay.
Another amazing singles contest.
Okay, reverse of fate.
The WWE Universe.
A twist of fate, this should do it. You're right, Cole, this should do it. I don't know how much longer he's going to be able to go.
Get to the top rope, hit the second swanton, and maybe get a win here. He's too far away. I'll try. Oh, whoa, okay. Come on. Get that pin, though. One, two, three. I beat the Undertaker. But now, to go to Night of Champions and beat the Undertaker for real, though, in a one-on-one match. Okay.
Let's see what happened during that incredible... Oh, they mesmerized the WWE Universe in that match. One in a million is the only way to just...
Here's your winner, Jeff Harvey.
What an incredible
they
match.
They call me Jeff Harvey. Okay. Okay, now, for the biggest match of this stream, me versus The Undertaker in a, actually I think it's just going to be a normal match, at Night of Champions. Unless it, of course, isn't a regular match. And, oh, number five. How gracious of you, Do 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 do. Night of Champions. One on one, me and the Undertaker. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna turn entrance on for this match.
This is a rivalry that will go down in WWE history. Does it come to an end tonight, We'll find out.
Hey guys, Tyler with GamingNextAGE. I'm bringing you a little thing from the Jeff Hardy series, live stream series. We are at Night of Champions, and it is me versus The Undertaker, our rival of right now. Okay. So, we good. Now, this is gonna be a good match. I mean, it's just gonna be a good match. The only match I've ever had with The Undertaker is on Superstars as Jeff Hardy. We just finished it on the live stream. If you want to see it, you have to go watch the full live stream replay. I don't know when it starts at. Let me shut up for Undertaker's entrance, though. Okay, I'm just gonna skip my entrance and we're gonna get this match started.
What we could see here is a classic chess match between.
Wait a second, gotta turn that my stream down so it doesn't sound weird in the actual stream while I'm streaming. Time warp everywhere. Okay. I'm watching myself stream while I'm streaming, and this video is coming out in the future. Mind explosion. So, we are, as you can obviously tell, fighting The Undertaker, the phenom of the WWE, a wrestling legend, and he's kind of kicking my ass right now, to be honest. We're doing this because, the last stream before this one, I asked, we had the choice of any wrestler in the game as to do as our rival and have a storyline with them. I asked, who do you want? And someone responded, The Undertaker. So, I jumped at that opportunity, and we are fighting The Undertaker right now. It is great, and I do truly like to interact with the fans. So if you want to come to a stream, I post a video a day in advance before I do a stream, and whenever I do a stream, it's usually always 4 o'clock Eastern Standard. If you want to have a good time, you should show up, and you should leave comments and interact, and it will be great. It will be very fun times.
To climb to the top and meet him there. Oh man, like he's begging him to bring it.
She had the need to feel the thunder. Okay, I'm actually doing well against The Undertaker. I thought he would be, like, destroying me a little.
Wow, cannot believe
I did barely manage to beat Taker earlier. And oh god.
The thing that got me was Undertaker.
He's doing old school. I didn't think that Carnation of Undertaker could do old school.
The EMT staff was in the middle of taking Mankind out of the match when Mankind jumped off the stretcher and walked back to the cell with a smile ear to ear and climbed the cage again.
So punishing. This is dangerous. Today, too fast.
Taker with the cover.
How did I? How did I not kick out at one?
An elbow. Oh, out of nowhere! I'll tell you something else, Cole. I am.
We are going for the United States Championship, but we took a bit of a pit stop to challenge the Undertaker.
He got choke slammed through the cell roof and fell 40 plus feet. For a second time in under 10 minutes. I mean, I think I speak for everyone when I say that match was one of the most memorable matches in the long history of The Undertaker.
Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy.
Oh!
Nigga. I thought why can't I speak? I don't know why I was saying JR. It's Michael Cole was like, bruh, Undertaker, he chokeslammed Mankind through a cage and things. And twist of fate on the outside. Bleh.
This could be the end.
I think it will be the end. Oh, look at the emotion.
I'm not going to go and get the pin yet. I mean, I can't get the pin on the outside, but when he comes in, I'm not going to get the pin either. Because I want to save my finisher for resiliency or something.
Oh, look at the emotion.
That was rough.
There we go.
Undertaker goes down.
I'm kicking you right in the tailbone. How does it feel?
I'm having a hard time figuring out what they're going to do next.
Okay. Oh, he's going to try to do his comeback moment. That was a cool DDT. I don't think I've ever done that before.
Oh, look at the emotion.
This is exactly how he drew this one up. The Undertaker is nearly 7 feet tall and 300 pounds. I mean, he can choke slam the nearly 500-pound Big Show. Clear the top rope with a dive under the floor and lock in a submission hold with the best of them. He truly is the Phenom.
Ow!
Good lord, that wasn't even close.
So that's what it's like being so far off the mark when this guy's on.
Undertaker just completely no-sold me. I kicked him in the stomach, he's like, eh, and then like kept going.
No, Undertaker.
Oh shit. Chokeslam.
Ain't gonna be long now.
Right. His minutes are numbered.
Get Shrek'd, son. Get Shrek'd.
Tremendous point earlier. The vast range of abilities the Undertaker can utilize against an opponent. He seems to be getting better,
right,
growing stronger as time goes on.
Well, Michael, I have to tell you, I have never seen someone so dominant for such a long period of time, and in so many ways, like the Undertaker. It really makes me proud. Well, it'll take a minor miracle to come back from this. I don't know how much more.
Try to hit that swanton, though. I don't think this is going to be enough to put him away. But I could sure try. Oh, shit. Why do I always fall for that? I literally always fall for that. Foot's under the rope. Kicked out anyways. Get wrecked, Blee. Wait, how did he get busted open? What? Somehow Undertaker started bleeding from him giving me a tombstone.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
Oh, out of nowhere!
We may have discovered his favorite move.
You think? He seems to use it often enough.
Okay, I got out of the snap minute, and now I'm gonna truck up Taker.
Oh wait, nice.
Oh shit!
Oh, that'll knock the wind out of you.
Oh, what a shot!
Gonna go for it again.
Serious damage.
And it connects that time.
And expect to be in the match much longer.
The more punishment he takes, the slower and slower.
I need to go and hit the Swanton, but. There's no point now. Taker's getting up.
Whoa, a direct hit. Talk about getting tagged.
Wait, I hit him in the back, and he's like, my elbow.
Boy, he just got laid out from the top.
Can I, four-star match, can I put Taker away right now? Come on. One, two, three. I can't believe it. Just like that, with a four-star match, I put away the Undertaker. That is another check mark off the career. That's another check mark on the list of accomplishments Jeff Hardy has done. Beaten the Phenom, the Undertaker. This has been Tyler from GamingNextAGE. I hope you have enjoyed, and goodbye. And hello, stream. I am still here. But I think I'm going to wrap up the stream, too. We've been going for an hour. It's going to do an interview with, what's her name? And then, I guess I'll wrap it up. And put a nice little bow on top. And, yes. Whoa, what's going on? Oh, it's the whole authority.
It's the authority. They look very pleased with his performance lately.
If the authority is on your side, you better run with it. They run this place and can do so much for your career.
And suddenly a wild authority appears. So Triple H and the whole crew are here. After our match with Taker, and I guess they're gonna congratulate me on beating the Undertaker, and yeah, I mean, this isn't too bad. I mean, do I shake his hand or no? I like how he hands his hand. I'm not joining the authority. I'm anti-authority. I'm a face. Faces are supposed to be anti-authority.
Can't expect the authority to take that lying down. You knew this was coming.
Well, you're either with them or against them. And tonight, he's
okay. Apparently, I'm getting my shit stomped in. That kind of sucks. Anyway, this has been Tyler here from GamingNextAGE. I hope you have enjoyed, and goodbye for real this time. But don't you worry, stream. I'm still here for you. Remember that. Okay. What's taking so long? I beat the Undertaker, which is an amazing feat. For me, at least. In my eyes, I am the all-powerful. I am no longer rivals with Taker. So now I can be rivals with anyone I want. Anyone I want. I don't know who to be rivals with, But I'll leave that to you. Next time, this has been Tyler here from GamingNextAGE. I hope you have enjoyed. And good. And goodbye, everyone. And while you're here, watch my videos.